across the nation from Watts, where 32 million people made in the image of God, though they were black, were murdered, came the cry, "Burn, baby, burn." Long time ago, that cry was originated by Nebuchadnezzar when he cast three Jewish boys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, in a fiery furnace, because they said, "Even if our God won't help us, we're not going to bow down to your God." And after they'd been in there, Nebuchadnezzar said, "Did we put only three in there?" "That's all." "So I see a fourth one in there. And he looks like the Son of God." And when they opened up the doors and they came out, they couldn't even smell the scorch upon their clothes. I want to talk about Burn, Baby, Burn, which was originated by Nebuchadnezzar, not by Watts. In Watts, it was a cry of last resort. People penned in a ghetto where there weren't even any buses to drive them to downtown Los Angeles to get their Social Security. People penned in a ghetto who were so poor that they didn't have cars. This is the land of the free and the home of the brave. So this was a cry of last resort. I'm not criticizing them. I understand what it means to be frustrated, what it means to be black. But it was a cry of the oppressed. Burn, baby, burn. Scorched earth policy of black people who had nowhere else to go. How else to call attention to their miserable conditions? But burn, baby, burn. Burn, baby, burn does more than call attention to a condition of, not second class, third class. Because we got second class citizens in the United States who belong to the white race. Black man in the United States is third class.
Come on, man.
But I'd like to say that burn, baby, burn is not the policy that I believe in. Because when the first rage in black communities burst forth with burn, baby, burn, it's our homes that are destroyed. When a neighborhood dry cleaner is burned down, it's our clothes that become ashes. When a supermarket in our community is set on fire, that's food for our babies, our children. I have never believed that violence can solve anything, whether on an international basis or on a community basis. The Chinese have a proverb that when you are in an argument, he who strikes the first blow confesses he's lost the argument. Show me a war in the history of the world that has solved the problem. Black men went out and fought World War I, World War II, Korean War, Vietnam War, to make the world safe for democracy, and they still have no equality. Still have no equality. So therefore I say, babies, it's learn, baby, learn. Learn. We need education to compete in this modern world of automation. We need education for skills. We need education that'll make us, educationally at least, the equal of the white man. Learn to be the best. Learn to be the best. Learn to be a leader. Learn to be a follower. Learn all these things that will equip you for this 20th century we're living in. Now, when you learn, baby, learn, then you can earn, baby, earn. And black power doesn't mean anything unless you have green power. Earn, baby, earn. Get that green in your pocket, baby. White man only respects two things. The white man only respects your vote and your dollar. The new trinity in the United States is God the Father, God the Son, and God the Almighty Dollar. Earn, baby, earn. Earn more money to educate your children, to break the chains. Break the chains. You hear what I said, baby? Break the chains. Break the chains of poverty. Break the chains of welfare. Break the chains of colonialism. Break the chains. Burn, baby, burn. I understand it. I know them personally. I understand them. But the thing is, learn, baby, learn, and be wise. And earn, baby, earn for survival. And if we must burn anything, let us burn the hatred out of their hearts. In fact, my feeling is that the black man has got to be the missionary to the white man. All these hundreds of years, the white man's been sending missionaries to Africa to save the black man's soul. Now the black man's got to start sending missionaries to save the white man's soul. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Because, you see, if it isn't for the black man, the world is finished, because two-thirds of the earth are black today. Two-thirds of the United Nations are black today. Let's don't talk about just the black man in the United States, 22 million, but let's realize, as Jesus once said, who's my neighbor? And the modern means of communication, transportation have made the world a whole neighborhood. We're all neighbors now. And two-thirds of this world now, black people. We are people made in the image of God, and God didn't say whether you're going to be black or white. He said, I'm going to make man in my image. And the spittle clay grew arrogant with breath. So learn, baby, learn. Learn, baby, learn. And keep the faith, baby. Sing a song.
Weep below, children, gentlemen, coming. Cause I heard Zion mourn. Weep below, children, gentlemen, coming. They walk from them to die by fire. Weep below, children, gentlemen, coming. Because the Lord was their desire. I said, weep below, children, gentlemen, coming. Cause I heard Zion mourn. Weep below, children, gentlemen, coming. I heard Zion mourn.
It's coming too, West. Judgment coming. West, judgment's coming.
Judgment's coming.
Judgment's coming.
Oh, weep below, children, judgment coming.
Bless your hearts.